And I'm back with George Packer talking about his book, The Unwinding. Since your book came out, have you noticed, where are we now? It's a little bit later. These questions about inequality that we were just talking about, president talks about them. You have a new mayor in New York who's certainly focused on them.
Well, first of all, nothing has happened in the year since I wrote the book mm-hmm. to make me think that maybe I was too pessimistic about the state of our institutions. Mm-hmm. Here in Washington, nothing seems to be working, mm-hmm. including the government, you know, just simply the function of government. Mm-hmm. And also the big themes of inequality and of the sense of elemental unfairness of just this, our American democracy no longer working on behalf of ordinary people as it has done in the past and as it should. That's a pretty widespread feeling. Mm-hmm. And it's interesting that President Obama has decided to make it really the signature of his second term is to do something about that. And mm-hmm. I think it comes from a sincere place in him. The question is, how can he, given all the blockage in our political system?
You know, the question is how serious is it, right? Because you even say at the beginning that you're describing that something that comes in cycles in this country. So, and some of your characters, there are reasons for hope, right? I mean, they're not giving, some are giving, seem to give up, not all of them.
Right. I mean, if you think about the years before the Civil War, political polarization had a different meaning back then.
Right.
If you think about the Great Depression, economic despair, you know, was a really deeper thing back then. Mm-hmm. I think what we have now is cynicism, is a sense that it's not going to get better or that it's not going to be done in the normal way by our leaders coming up with better policies and new deals, new mm-hmm. bargains, because mm-hmm. the institutions they lead and the leaders themselves seem to have defaulted. And that's a big theme of the book, and it's what all of the characters in the book seem to feel. And so, yes, if I feel hope, it's when I'm in rural North Carolina driving around the Piedmont with Dean Price, who's this former truck stop owner turned biodiesel entrepreneur who wants to save the fallen economy of rural North Carolina by using waste restaurant oil to make diesel fuel. To me, that's kind of exciting. And he's exciting because he has a vision. He has a lot mm-hmm. of faith in it. When I'm in New York and Washington, and even in golden Silicon Valley, I have this sense that people are sort of fighting and jockeying over smaller and smaller stakes and have lost sort of the big vision that mm-hmm. Americans are known for.
Just ask you one more question, picking up on what you were saying about some of the famous people that are in this book. Well, how did you think about them in terms of fitting them into this larger picture? And we're talking about people like, you mentioned Oprah, Jay-Z, Colin Powell, Robert Rubin, list goes on.
I wanted representatives from different parts of our culture. So politics. To me, Newt Gingrich I think history is going to look at him as a crucial figure for our time mm-hmm. because he shaped what we now think of as sort of a rather toxic and partisan political atmosphere. I think he, as much as anyone, came to Congress in order to do that. Mm-hmm. Robert Rubin, you know, he was sort of a revered figure from Wall Street and Washington who turned out not to really know what was going on or to not be, you know, have his hands on the wheel enough to be able to prevent it. And the financial crisis came and he seemed as taken by surprise as anyone, and yet he had real responsibilities mm-hmm. there. Mm-hmm. Sam Walton, mm-hmm. The founder of Walmart, comes from the world of business. Walmart is sort of, you know, a key company for our time. It has, I think, triggered a race to the bottom. Prices plummet and wages plummet. Mm-hmm. And we are, in the departure.
And people go to it
of
and
course.
They continue it.
And they have,
they
some,
love it.
Some love it and some have to go there. The Hartzell family, who Danny Hartzell worked there, they also have to shop there because mm-hmm. they can't afford to shop anywhere else. So in a sense, everything is being pushed down. And then, you know, there's also Jay-Z, who I think is a fascinating rags-to-riches story, who kind of represents to me someone coming from the bottom and fighting his way to the top in a way that says, break the rules. Don't wait your turn. Don't put one foot in front of the other, because that's a sucker's game. It's rigged. The only way to the top is by getting away with murder, which is something he said in his own autobiography. So there's something slightly sinister about the success of Jay-Z and the vision of life that he puts forward in his raps.
All right, The Unwinding, an inner history of the new America. George Packer, thanks so much.
My pleasure.